10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hello guys, DreamMaker here. In the last video I showed you how to make a PCB, but after making a printed circuit board you'll need to drill the holes to place the components. I don't have this kind of drill press, so I thought why not make one. I salvaged some parts from an old printer, a 30 volt powerful DC motor and two stainless steel rods. I made some sketches, I'll put them in a link below along with everything you need, be sure to check it out. Let's start this tutorial. I began by cutting the frame from a sheet of plywood with a thickness of 1 cm using my table mounted jigsaw. It's a bit rough to work with and sometimes with small pieces it gets dangerous, but it'll do the job for now. I sand the edges of all the cuts to make them smoother. I'm using these L-shaped joints and some screws to join all the pieces together. I marked their places, then I added glue to the bottom piece to secure it to the base, which is a scrap piece of MDF. I made sure the L joints are perpendicular enough, then drilled the holes to fit the steel rods before adding the sides. And now we get to work on the slider. The holes are slightly bigger because I can't make them 100% straight, especially with this drill and a 10 mm drill bit. So the moving piece have more degrees of freedom than the sketch I planned to make in the first place. But this made the mini drill even easier to work with, you'll see it later. X, the two pieces that will hold the motor in place. For the inner hole, it got messy, so be careful if you're doing it like me, a bandsaw is what you need. Next, I filed it until I was able to fit the motor easily. Added holes to mount them to the slider like this. Now finishing the slider by adding the slots to fit the two pieces using a saw and a chisel. Next, I secured them with some glue to hold the alignment until I added the screws. Finally, don't forget to drill the two holes to fit the zip tie. Now I'm marking the head of the motor to know where it will drop and drill the hole. For now, see you in the next part. We complete the build and start drilling some tiny holes with it. It came out surprisingly handy to work with. Keep safe and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, you definitely should.